So hi everyone and welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. So पिछले एक हफ्ते से due to certain reasons the sessions could not be conducted, but don't you worry guys, जब तक मैं हूँ आपके सारे PIB के session, आपके सारे PIB के releases cover होंगे, alright? So in today's session we are going to cover the PIB news from 25th to 31st of October 2022 and whatever is the backlog, everything will be covered. You guys just don't worry, right? और अभी recently कोई examination भी नहीं है. But yes, I will, मैं बहुत ढीला नहीं करूंगा काम, ठीक है? I will not delay the process, but yes, everything will be covered in very short interval of time, alright? So, आज हम कर लेते हैं अक्टूबर तक का, 25th to 31st अक्टूबर, उसके बाद नवंबर का जो भी बाकी है, that will be covered in the upcoming classes, alright? So, let's begin with the session guys, without any delay, and let's talk about the very first question, but before we begin, remember, if you want to have the PDF of this session, you can join the Telegram channel, the link is provided in the description. And remember, some people were asking that answers jo hai wo nahi milte unko PDF mein. So guys, let me tell you this here. Abhi yahan pe aapko nahi dikh raha hoga, but when you get the PDF at this position, you'll get the answer, right? Bottom right corner pe aap jab dekhoge to aapko answer mil jayega, theek hai na? So let's talk about the very first question. Consider the following statements about Competition Commission of India and you have to identify the incorrect statement. Now, why we are discussing about Competition Commission of India? Because Competition Commission of India has imposed a penalty of rupees 936.44 crores on Google. Now, ab aap soch rahe hoge bhai aise to bahut sari wo penalty lagata rehta hai, aaj tak to aapne nahi padhaya, ab kyun padha rahe ho? Isliye, because this penalty is important, because it is imposed on a very important company and that is Google, alright? Now, why this penalty has been imposed? So, it has been imposed for abusing its dominant position with respect to its Play Store policy, which means Google was using its dominant position with respect to its Play Store policy, and that is why basically it was disturbing the competition, the competitive thing in the country, and that is why this penalty has been imposed. And now let's talk about the Competition Commission of India. But remember one thing guys, they are not going to ask anything, I believe, from this penalty wala part. That is not important for you. But yeah, remember that this much amount of penalty was imposed on Google, 936.44 crores. But let's talk about Competition Commission of India. What is this organization? What it does? Let's talk about it. So remember, this organization was established in the year 2003, right? In the year 2003. To eliminate practices having adverse effect on competition, to promote and sustain competition, and to protect the interests of consumers and ensure the freedom of trade. Alright, so that is the objective of this Competition Commission of India. Basically, to promote and sustain competition, that is the major objective of this organization. It was established in 2003 with its headquarters in New Delhi. And it is a statutory body which was established under Competition Act of 2002. Now, statutory bodies are those which are established under any act, okay? It functions under the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, right? Please don't get confused here. Some people are confused that it works under the Ministry of Finance. It is not like that. It works under the Ministry of Corporate Affairs. It consists of a chairperson and six members appointed by the central government, and currently acting chairperson is Sangeeta Verma. Who is the acting chairperson? Sangeeta Verma. So, let's wait for the permanent chairperson. Who is the acting chairperson? Is Sangeeta Verma. Alright, so that is all, and now let's come back to the question. So you have to identify the incorrect statement, okay? So it is the chief national competition regulator in India. Yes, this is absolutely correct. It is a statutory body established under Competition Act of 2002. Ye bhi sahi baat hai. It functioned under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Is that so? No. It works under the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, which is headed by Nirmala Sitharaman, right? And it is headquartered in Mumbai. No, it is headquartered in New Delhi. So this is also incorrect. 1 and 2 are correct, but we have to identify the incorrect. So therefore, the correct answer will be none of the above. None of the above will be the correct answer, because none, 3 and 4 are incorrect. Okay, let me check it once again. So this is correct, this is correct, this is 3, this is 4. Okay, so none of the above will be the correct answer, guys. Okay, moving ahead to question number 2. When was the Target Olympic Podium Scheme, which in short is TOPS, right, launched by Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports, which is headed by Mr. Anurag Thakur, to identify, groom and prepare potential medal prospective athletes for Olympics and Paralympic Games? Now, this scheme is all about providing support to the athletes so that they can, they can move ahead, they can groom themselves, and they can hedge medals for the country. All right, so that is the whole idea behind this scheme. So remember, the objective of this scheme is to identify, groom and prepare the potential medal prospective athletes for the country so that they can win medals for the country at international sporting events, be it Olympic, be it Commonwealth, koi bhi ho. It was launched in the year 2014, but it was revamped in the year 2018. Of course, the ministry is Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports. Now, iske baare mein hum isliye padh rahe hain because certain amount kisi ek athlete ko diya gaya tha. So that is not important, but yes, ye scheme important ho jati hai. Now remember, under the scheme, now we are talking about the government is providing support to the athletes. Now what type of support is this? Now remember, this support includes foreign training, international competition equipment and coaching camps, and beside a monthly stipend of rupees 50,000 for each athlete. Alright, so that is the support which is being provided by the government of India through Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports. Alright, so yeah, that is all. And the question is regarding the launch year. So it was launched in the year 2014. Now please don't get confused between 2014 and 18, because 2018 is the year when it was revamped, right? But if someone asks you that when it was launched, so the answer would be 2014. Moving ahead to question number 3. Identify correct statements about ASEAN. Again, we are talking about ASEAN. It is an international organization, or you can say the regional organization. So iske bare mein hum isliye pad rahe hain because recently the 7th ASEAN India ministerial meeting on agriculture and forestry was held virtually, and it was co-chaired by Union Minister for Agriculture. And who is the minister? Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar, and his Lok Sabha constituency is Morena in Madhya Pradesh, right? And this meeting was done to review the progress in implementation of various programs and activities under the medium term action plan of ASEAN India cooperation. So we have a cooperation with ASEAN countries or the ASEAN organization, right? And then we have a medium term action plan in the area of agriculture. So to review the progress of that medium term action plan, this meeting was conducted, right? Now let's talk about ASEAN. So remember, it was established in the year 1967 through Bangkok Declaration to accelerate economic growth, and through that economic growth to accelerate social progress and cultural development. ठीक है, बेसिकली इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ, सोशल ग्रोथ एंड कल्चरल ग्रोथ, इन तीनों के लिए दिस आसियान ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वॉज फॉर्म्ड. एंड ऑफ कोर्स आल्सो टू प्रमोट रीजनल पीस एंड स्टेबिलिटी बेस्ड ऑन द रूल ऑफ लॉ एंड प्रिंसिपल ऑफ यूनाइटेड नेशन चार्टर, राइट? किसी भी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का ना, अगर आपको ऑब्जेक्टिव समझ नहीं आ रहा होगा ना, तो एक ये वाला ऑब्जेक्टिव तो जरूर लिख के आ जाना, राइट? अगर मान लो कभी कुछ आइडिया नहीं आ रहा है, तो ये वाला जरूर लिख लेना, और उसमें एक वर्ड ऐड कर देना, इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ. ठीक है, ये तो होता ही होता है. इफ यू ड्यूरिंग द एग्जामिनेशन इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू रिकॉल द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड यू हैव टू राइट इट, देन राइट अबाउट, देन राइट दिस लाइन, दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन प्रमोट द रीजनल पीस एंड स्टेबिलिटी, राइट? एंड और यू कैन राइट दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन प्रमोट द इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ. ओके, इट्स सेक्रेटेरियट इज लोकेटेड इन जकार्ता इन इंडोनेशिया, एंड इट इज अ पॉलिटिकल एंड इकोनॉमिक यूनियन ऑफ 10 मेंबर स्टेट्स. वी ऑल नो देर आर 10 members countries in ASEAN, and these are the 10 member states. And I would suggest you to remember the name of all the states, because humne dekha hai UPSC ke exam mein ek bar hua tha, I think last to last year in the preliminary examination, they have asked which of the following is not one of the member of G20 nation. So in that case, abko G20 ke sare members pata honi chahiye, 19 countries plus one European Union. All right, so similarly they can ask you from here as well. So you can remember it. और ऐसे नहीं कि अब एक बार बैठ के याद कर रहे हैं, ऐसे नहीं, पढ़ते रहोगे वो अपने आप ही याद हो जाएगा. एंड ऑफकोर्स ऑप्शन विल हेल्प इन ड्यूरिंग द एग्जामिनेशन. ठीक है ना? सो नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. इट इज अ पॉलिटिकल एंड इकोनॉमिक यूनियन ऑफ 10 मेंबर स्टेट्स इन साउथ ईस्ट एशिया, करेक्ट? इट वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन 1967 थ्रू बैंकॉक डिक्लेरेशन, ये भी बात सही है. इट्स सेक्रेटेरियट इज लोकेटेड इन मनीला, नॉट मनीला, इट इज इन जकार्ता इन इंडोनेशिया. And China is a member of ASEAN. No, China, I don't think, is a member of ASEAN. So we have to identify correct statement, which means option A, 1 and 2 only will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 4. Blue flag certification is given to the cleanest beaches in the world to promote sustainability in the tourism sector. It is awarded by Denmark-based Foundation for Environment Education. Recently, the certification has been awarded to two beaches in India, which is Minicoy Thundi and Kadamat Beach. So where is this Kadmat beach located? So you must have heard of these two beaches getting the blue flag certification in India, and the very first beach to get blue flag certification in India was Chandrabhag beach, right? It is in Odisha. And now after the inclusion of these two beaches, now we have 12 beaches in the country which have this blue flag certification. All right. Now, remember, this international eco label is given to the cleanest beaches in the world, and already humne question mein padh liya that Minicoy Thundi beach and Kadmat beach, both are located in Lakshadweep. These were accorded the blue flag certification. Now, talking about blue flag certification, so the objective behind certifying the beaches as the blue flag certified beaches is to promote sustainability in the tourism sector through environmental education, environmental protection, and other sustainable development practices. It is awarded by Foundation for Environment Education, which is in Denmark, and there are total around 33 criteria based on which these blue flag certification are given. Okay, and these are the 12 blue flag certified beaches in the country with their location. All right, so that is all. Okay, so where is Kadmat beach located? It is located in Lakshadweep. Option C is the correct answer. All right. Let's talk about question number 5 then. Identify incorrect statements about G20. Now we are talking about G20. Why we are talking about G20? Because Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare, Dr. Mansukh Mandavia, he is also the Minister of Chemical and Fertilizer, addressed the second G20 Health Ministers meeting in Bali in Indonesia. Now the purpose of this meeting was to discuss the progress and way forward on priorities in the healthcare sector. Of course, when there is a meeting of health ministers, then of course the priority was the healthcare sector, the progress in the healthcare sector. Okay. So talking about G20, so remember, it is a multilateral platform connecting the world's major developed and emerging economies, and it has 19 countries and one European Union. So that is why it is called as G20, right? It works to address major issues related to global economy, such as international financial stability, climate change, mitigation, and sustainable development. So basic objective. It was established in 1999 and it has no permanent secretariat. Aur har saal iski presidency change hoti rehti hai. Next year it will be with India, right? Starting from 1st of December 2022 till 30th November 2023, the presidency will be with India. Currently the presidency is with Indonesia, and that is why all the summit took place this year in Indonesia, right? And these are the G20 members. All right. So that is all. And now let's come back to the question. It is a multilateral platform connecting the world's major developed and emerging economies. Sahi baat hai. It was established in 1999. Bilkul sahi baat hai. G20 member countries collectively represent more than 90% of the world's GDP and 85% of the international trade. It is not 90%. I think it is 80%. It is mentioned in the slide. Yeah. 80% of the world GDP ko ye represent karte hain, and this information is taken from the website, so that don't worry, it is correct. Its permanent secretariat is located at Washington DC, US. No, it has no permanent secretariat. And India will assume the presidency of G20 for 1 year, starting from 1st December 2020 to 20th November 2023, right? So this is, I think, correct. 1, 2 and 5 are okay, but we have to identify the incorrect statement 3 and 4. Okay, 3 and 4 are not here. I think there is some mistake with the options. I'll change the options and my PDF mein changes kar dunga, right? Okay, let me check it once again. This is incorrect, this is incorrect, this is correct. Yeah, with these 3 and 4 are incorrect. Okay, so I'll make the changes in the options. Don't worry. Theek hai na? Aapko PDF mein sahi hoke milega. Question number 6, very very important. As per the third advance estimates of horticulture crops for the year 21-22, what is the total estimate production of horticulture crops in the year 2021-22? Right, very very important question. So the third advance estimates for horticulture crops has been released, and not only the production estimate, the area, jitne area mein isko grow kiya hai, that has also been released by the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, right? And according to the estimates, a record 342.33 million tons are estimated to be produced in an area of 28.08 million hectares. And it is an increase of 2.3% ओवर द ईयर 2020-21 2020-21 से कितना परसेंट ज्यादा है 2.3% एंड इट इज अ रिकॉर्ड ओके रिकॉर्ड प्रोडक्शन होगा नाउ फॉर अदर क्रॉप्स अगर हम क्रॉप्स की बात करें देखो जनरली दे विल आस्क यू दी ओवरऑल ठीक है ना बट यस अगर एग्जामिनर का मूड खराब हो जाए और वो कुछ भी पूछना चाहे तो पूछ सकता है तो फॉर फ्रूट्स इट इज 107.24 फॉर वेजिटेबल 204.84 अनियन 31.27 पोटेटोज 53.39 एंड टोमेटो 20.33 ऑलराइट सो दैट इज ऑल एंड हियर द क्वेश्चन इज रिगार्डिंग द टोटल एस्टिमेटेड प्रोडक्शन सो दैट्स 342.33 मिलियन टन्स ऑलराइट मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 7 Recently, Union Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare constituted two committees to reduce the delay in crop loss or damage estimation and ensure timely settlement of claims by farmers under weather-based crop insurance schemes, including Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. Both committees are being headed by. In dono committees ko kaun head kar rahe hain? So these are the two committees which are being headed by Dr. C.S. Murthy. Right? Dr. C.S. Murthy is the Chairperson of these committees and who is Dr. C.S. Murthy by the way. So he is the director of Mahalanobis National Crop Forecast Center. Right. Now what are these two committees? Number one is Committee for Nationwide Implementation of Technology Based Crop Yield Estimation. How we can estimate the crop yield. Right. With the help of technology. This is the objective of this committee. And then we have Committee for Standardization and Improvement of Weather Data Infrastructure. How we can improve the weather data infrastructure. Right, this committee will work towards this thing. Now, talking about first committee, so it will help the Agriculture Ministry in creation of the proposed WINDS. Now, what is this WINDS? It is Weather Information Network Data System. Now, what will happen under WINDS? There will be a system of automatic weather station and automatic rain gauges will and both these things will help in crop yield estimation. ठीक है? वो कैसे होगा? क्योंकि हमें वेदर का पता होगा वेदर से हमें बारिश का पता चलेगा और ऑटोमेटिक रेन गॉजेस की मदद से हमें इंटेंसिटी और ड्यूरेशन का पता चलेगा ऑफ द रेनफॉल एंड देन विल बी एबल टू एस्टिमेट द क्रॉप यील्ड ओके सो इट इज रिटन हियर रिमेंबर ऑटोमेटिक रेन गॉज इज एन इंस्ट्रूमेंट यूज फॉर मेजरिंग इंटेंसिटी एंड ड्यूरेशन ऑफ रेनफॉल ऑलराइट नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट द सेकेंड कमिटी सो इट विल प्रिपेयर एसओपीज फॉर द टेक्नोलॉजी इंप्लीमेंटेशन पार्टनर्स फ्रॉम विच स्टेट्स एंड From which states have to select anyone. So basically what will happen is that this committee will prepare standard operating procedure and it will also enroll the technology implementing partners from which and out of these technology implementing partners states will choose one. Okay. Now these technology implementing partners will suggest the technologies that can be used for improving the weather data infrastructure. All right. I hope. There is no doubt. अगर कोई doubt होगा तो please you guys can ask me in the comment section. Let me repeat once again because थोड़ा सा technical है यहाँ पे. Number one जो पहली committee है the objective is the creation of the proposed WINDS. Now what is WINDS? Weather Information Network Data System. So basically a system will be created which will provide information regarding the weather and with the help of that we would be able to estimate the crop yield. All right and then the second committee is for weather data infrastructure under which certain technology implementing partners will be enrolled and these partners will suggest the technologies that can be used for improving the weather data infrastructure. Okay, I hope I'm clear now and now the correct answer is Dr. C.S. Murthy, option D. Moving ahead to question number 8, recently E-Saras portal and e-commerce portal has been launched for better and more effective marketing of Saras products prepared by women self-help groups. It is an initiative of which ministry? Now, Saras products ke baare mein agar hum baat kare to remember, Saras is a brand actually. Theek hai, aapne dekha hoga kahi jagahon pe Saras ghee, Saras doodh, right? Saras is a brand actually and it was launched by Ministry of Rural Development to provide market access to the products which are being prepared by the self-help groups, right? And for that, taking one step ahead, Ministry of Rural Development has now launched eSaras Commerce Portal, eSaras e-commerce portal, all right? Now it will help in better and more effective marketing of Saras products prepared by women of self-help groups. It's aur achhi marketing hogi, aur achhi branding hogi and the women self-help groups will be able to sell their products online as well, okay? The objective of this portal, of course, is to showcase the products, to connect the artisans with potential customers, and of course, to enhance the livelihoods of the rural people. It has been launched under National Rural Livelihood Mission. Do remember this, it is important. And it has been developed by Digital India Corporation, which works under the Ministry of Electronics and IT, headed by Mr. Ashwini Vaishnav. Alright. And remember, during the event, this food festival was also launched, which is Saras Food Festival. And this festival provided the self-help groups with the opportunity to showcase their skills in the field of food making and introducing people to the food culture of the country. Alright. And it took place in New Delhi. Remember this also. The Saras Food Festival took place in New Delhi and it was inaugurated by Minister of State for Rural Development. But remember, who is the Union Minister of Rural Development? It's Mr. Giriraj Singh. And Giriraj Singh's Lok Sabha constituency is Begusarai, which we all know is in Bihar. Okay. Alright, so the correct answer is what? Option D, Ministry of Rural Development, headed by Giriraj Singh. And Giriraj Singh is also the Minister of Panchayati Raj. Alright. Let's talk about question number 9 then. Identify the correct statements about Investor Education and Protection Fund Authority. Investor Education and Protection Fund Authority ke baare mein aapko correct statement batana hai. But the question is why we are discussing it. Because recently an Investor Education Awareness and Protection Conference took place in Srinagar in Jammu and Kashmir. And it was organized by Investor Education and Protection Fund Authority. And that is why we are discussing about this authority. Now remember, this conference took place to share ideas about inclusive financial literacy, investor awareness and protection for overall economic growth and nation building. Alright. So basically, Jammu Kashmir mein bhi in cheezon ki zarurat hai. So that is why this conference was organized. Alright. Now talking about this authority. So remember, the objective is to make refunds of shares, unclaimed dividends, mature deposits, deposits or debentures to the investors, to promote awareness among investors and protecting their interest. And with this objective, this awareness campaign was conducted in Jammu and Kashmir, and to administer the Investor Education and Protection Fund. And it was established in the year 2016 under Section 125 of the Companies Act of 2013. And when we are talking about Companies Act, the parent ministry must be the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, MCA. All right. Now talking about this fund, Investor Education and Protection Fund. So it was set up in 1999 under the Ministry of Corporate Affairs with an aim to promote the investors' awareness and protection of the interest of investors. The amounts transferred to this fund includes, kya kya amount hota hai iske andar? It includes dividends, it includes applications money. Okay, let me underline this. Applications money, it includes mature deposits, etc. that have remained unpaid or unclaimed for a period of 7 years or more. 7 saal tak agar koi bhi amount inme se unpaid ya fir unclaimed reh jata hai, so that amount is credited to the Investor Education and Protection Fund. Right? And this fund is maintained under the Consolidated Fund of India, which is mentioned under Article 266 of the Constitution. Alright? So now let's talk about this question. It was established in 2016 under subsection 5 of Section 125 of Companies Act 2013. Bilkul sahi baat hai, there is no problem. It promotes awareness among investors and protect their interests. This is also correct. It functioned under the administrative control of Union Finance Ministry. No, MCA ke under kaam karta hai ye. And it administers Investor Education and Protection Fund. Ye bilkul sahi baat hai. So correct statement identify karna hai. 1, 2 and 4 should be the correct answer. Option B. Alright. Moving ahead to question number 10. Which ministry has signed MOU with FIFA and All India Football Federation for launching football for schools initiative and in India? Now remember, FIFA chairperson is Mr. Gianni Infantino. I hope you all know this. So football for schools initiative in India has been launched, and it has been launched by Ministry of Education, which is headed by Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan. And for this, an MOU has been signed with FIFA and All India Football Federation. Now what is the objective of this football for schools? So this initiative will empower 25 million young boys and girls in India through sports integrated learning, which is the sports integrated learning has also has been emphasized in the new education policy of 2020 as well. So this initiative is on the lines of new education policy 2020. All right, and it espouses the spirit of NEP 2020 by using football as a positive tool to inspire children and ensure their holistic development. Okay. Now, these are some of the benefits that this initiative will give to the boys and girls. So you can read from the PDF. Now, ये सारी चीजें याद मत करने लग जाना. These are for the basic understanding that okay, why we are launching this initiative. Yeah. Yeah, why government has launched this initiative. All right. So therefore, the correct answer is option C, Ministry of Education, headed by Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan, and he is also the Minister of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. Do remember this as well. Question number 11. Identify correct statements about negotiable warehouse receipts. Now, what is this negotiable warehouse receipts? तो इसके बारे में बात करते हैं, then फिर question पे आएंगे. It is in news because Warehousing Development and Regulatory Authority recently organized a seminar on ENWR, which is negotiable warehouse receipt, an effective tool for promoting pledge financing. ठीक है जी, अब सब कुछ धरती गोल हो गई, कुछ समझ नहीं आया कि आखिर negotiable warehouse receipt होता क्या है. That is important to understand. Remember, it helps farmers to store their produce in a scientific storage godowns or warehouse, ठीक है, and to seek loan from banks against their NWR. Now, what is this NWR again? अभी भी clear नहीं हुई बात. देखो क्या होता है, मैं बताता हूँ. This is a farmer A. He goes to his nearby storage godown, right? ये एक storage godown के पास जाता है. This is a storage godown X. He store his produce in these godowns, ठीक है, and in return of that produce, he gets a receipt, and this receipt can be used to take loan from the banks. These receipts can be traded as well, right? आप समझ रहे हो मेरी बात को. Basically उसने क्या किया, अपना सामान वहां पे रखा, उसके बदले में एक receipt ले ली, right? और वो जो रिसीट है वो एक नेगोशिएबल इंस्ट्रूमेंट की तरह काम कर रही है, अंडर नेगोशिएबल इंस्ट्रूमेंट की तरह काम कर रही है. नेगोशिएबल इंस्ट्रूमेंट मतलब उससे ट्रेडिंग की जा सकती है, उससे बैंक से लोन लिया जा सकता है. ऑलराइट, आई होप यू गॉट माय पॉइंट. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ नेगोशिएबल वेयरहाउस रिसीट? इट वॉज लॉन्च, दिस इनिशिएटिव वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 2011. तो यहां से एक बार रीड आउट कर लेते हैं. सो दीज आर द वेयरहाउस रिसीट्स इश्यूड बाय WDRA अप्रूव्ड वेयरहाउसेस टू डिपॉजिट to farmers, or you can say depositors, against commodities deposited in warehouses. ठीक है ना, they can be traded, sold, swapped, and also can be used as collateral to support borrowing or loan from the bank. ठीक है, I hope आपको मैंने ये clear कर दिया है पहले ही. And they were made negotiable instruments also. These come under the negotiable instruments under the Warehouse Development and Regulation Act of 2007. And these are regulated by WDRA, which is Warehousing Development and Regulatory Authority. This is, guys, very very important. I hope आपको ये clear हुआ है. Let me repeat it once again. Let's say there is a farmer A and he does not have storage godown. ठीक है? Let's say there is a farmer A and he does not have his own storage godown. So he goes to a nearby storage godown. ठीक है? He stores his produce in this godown. ठीक है? इस godown में अपना क्या करता है? जो भी produce है उसका, उसको store कर देता है. ठीक है, इन द रिटर्न ऑफ हिज प्रोड्यूस ही गेट्स अ सर्टेन रिसीट व्हिच इज नोन एज नेगोशिएबल वेयरहाउस रिसीट. नाउ दिस नेगोशिएबल वेयरहाउस रिसीट, लेट्स से एक्स, दिस नेगोशिएबल वेयरहाउस रिसीट कैन बी यूज्ड, कैन बी ट्रेडेड, कैन बी सोल्ड, एंड इट कैन बी यूज्ड एज अ कोलैटरल फॉर टेकिंग लोन फ्रॉम द बैंक्स. ऑलराइट, आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. सो इट वाज लॉन्च्ड इन 2011 अंडर WDRA एक्ट 2007. सही बात है, दीज आर रेगुलेटेड बाय WDRA, ये भी सही है. These are issued by WDRA approved warehouses to depositors or farmers against commodities deposited in warehouses. This is also correct. They can be traded, sold or swapped. ये भी सही है. They cannot be used as collateral. Oh, they can be used. So this is incorrect. 1, 2, 3 and 4 should be the correct answer. Option D. ठीक है ना? Moving ahead to question number 12. Which organization has successfully developed two dwarf varieties of Kala Namak rice, also known as Buddha rice, named as Pusa Narendra Kala Namak 1638 and Pusa Narendra Kala Namak 1652. Now such questions can be asked in the NABARD examination. That is why such question is included. So this organization is Indian Agricultural Research Institute. Option E is the correct answer. Alright. Question number 13. 7th edition of India Water Week is organized by Ministry of Water. No. This is complete error. This should be Department of. Okay. दिस इज नॉट मिनिस्ट्री, दिस इज डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ, बिकॉज मिनिस्ट्री इज नाउ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ जल शक्ति एज वी ऑल नो, डिपार्टमेंट, ऑलराइट, मिनिस्ट्री इज नाउ नोन एज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ जल शक्ति. ओके, विद द थीम वॉटर सिक्योरिटी फॉर सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट एंड इक्विटी, विच आर दी पार्टनर कंट्रीज फॉर इंडिया वॉटर वीक 2022. सो रिमेंबर देर वर थ्री पार्टनर्स, दीज वर डेनमार्क, सिंगापुर एंड फिनलैंड. सो 1, 2, and 3 शुड बी द करेक्ट आंसर, ऑप्शन सी, राइट. एंड इससे ज्यादा इसमें पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है, देर इज नो नीड. इंडिया केम 2022 विल बी ऑर्गेनाइज बाई डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिकल एंड फर्टिलाइजर्स इन एसोसिएशन विद फिक्की. इट्स थीम इज विजन 2030, केमिकल्स एंड पेट्रोकेमिकल्स बिल्ड इंडिया, वेयर इट विल बी हेल्ड, वेयर इट विल टेक प्लेस. सो इट विल टेक प्लेस इन न्यू दिल्ली, द कैपिटल ऑफ कंट्री. ऑप्शन डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. Where was the first ASEAN-India startup festival organized to further strengthen ASEAN-India cooperation to accelerate the startup economy? So where it took place? So it was the first edition and it took place in Bogor, which is in Indonesia. Okay. Question number 16. Which country hosted the first Global Digital Health Summit Expo and Innovation Awards organized in partnership with global bodies working in digital health? And co-hosted by Internet Governance Forum, United Nations. Now, in such things, only they ask you the host country, the host organization, if it is there. Okay. In this case, the host country is there, and it is India. Option D, Hamara Pyara Bharat. And in Bharat, it took place in New Delhi. Question number 17. According to WEO, World Energy Outlook, electricity generation through coal will peak around 2030, rising from 240 gigawatt in 2021 to 275 gigawatt in 2030. Moreover, by 2030, over 60% of growth in power demand will be met by renewables, accounting for 35% of electricity mix. WEO is flagship annual publication of which organization? Very simple question. It is the publication of International Energy Agency, which is headquartered in Paris. Right, option D is the correct answer, and Paris has also the headquarters of UNESCO and Reporters Without Borders as well. Right, and this is the organization which releases that report. I'm forgetting the name of that report, Reporters Without Borders organization. Bahut hi common si report hai. Okay, I am unable to recall the name of that report. Okay, I'm sorry, main aapko comment section mein comment karke bata dunga. Which country recently hosted the special meeting of United Nations Security Council's Counter-Terrorism Committee? Now remember, this is again took place in India. Without any doubt, option C is the correct answer, and there is no need to go into the details. NDC, Nationally Determined Contribution Synthesized Report, is the annual summary of climate commitments made by the countries under the Paris Agreement 2015 and their impact on global greenhouse gas emissions. It is released by which of the following organization? So it is released by UNFCCC. Option A is the correct answer, right? Question number 20. Which central public sector enterprise became the first to achieve the major milestone of procurement value of 10,000 crore through the government e-marketplace? Now this CPAC is Steel Authority of India Limited. Option C is the correct answer. And Soma Mandal is the MD and CEO. Soma Mandal, she was the first MD and CEO of SAIL. After Telangana and Haryana, which state has become the third big state to be declared 100% Har Ghar Jal state under Jal Jeevan Mission, right? And of course, the target is to provide tap water in the rural areas by the year 2024, and that this mission is known as what? Har Ghar Jal Mission, right? And the third state to achieve this feat is Gujarat. Option B is the correct answer. All right, and that's it for today's session, guys. I hope the questions and their explanations are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Aur jo corrections hai PDF mein, ek question mein wo main kar dunga, don't worry, you'll get the corrected PDF. Okay, milte hain fir next session mein on Wednesday. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.